Some important new reporting this hour on the January 6th committee and at least one of its witnesses. Sources now tell CNN the panel's star witness from the other day, the former White House aide, Cassidy Hutchinson, was contacted by former colleagues in an attempt to influence her testimony. CNN's Caitlin Polance is with us in leading this reporting. This would be a wow. What do you know?
It would indeed. So Cassidy Hutchinson did tell the committee that she was contacted by someone attempting to influence her testimony. This is being confirmed now by Casey Hunt, Ryan Noble, Zach Cohen, all of our colleagues doing this great reporting. And this is something right now that is fleshing out a mystery that Liz Cheney teed up at this hearing on Tuesday. On Tuesday, as Cassidy Hutchinson is sitting there at the end of the testimony, Liz Cheney turns and says, she raises this specter of witness tampering, and she describes that the committee, as they're bringing witnesses in, has been asking them, has anyone contacted you? Has any former colleagues contacted you? Can you tell us about any attempts to impact your testimony? And Cheney did not reveal who the witnesses were. We can say now one was Cassidy Hutchinson, but both witnesses that Cheney gave examples of received phone calls. And these phone calls, Cheney quoted them being things like people saying, telling witnesses, do the right thing. You want to stay in good graces in the Trump world. Trump does read transcripts of these hearings. Make sure you're aware of that. Another call someone received was that someone was saying to the witness that he, an unnamed person, wants me to let you know he's thinking about you and you're going to do the right thing when you go in for your deposition. So we don't have more information about exactly which one of these examples Cassidy Hutchinson is, but she did sit for four closed-door depositions with the committee, and it is something that the committee has promised they'll return to.
And I'm guessing we don't know the answer to this question yet. Congresswoman Cheney, the vice chair, did promise this would come up at a further hearing. Do we know, in Cassidy Hutchinson's case, who the phone call was from?
We don't at this time.
We don't at this time. Let's bring the conversation from Shan Wu was in that very chair when we were having this conversation yesterday. And he said the significance of this is that it's hard to prove a conspiracy. It's hard to prove some of these things. And sometimes it's hard to prove legal intent. If Trump is going to continue to insist he won the election, even though that's ludicrous, it might be hard to convince a jury he knew what he was doing is wrong. Witness tampering, Shan made the point, is pretty clear cut under the law. If you have an email, you can trace back where it came from. Somebody's paying attention.
Yeah, and I think it just, again, goes to the point of if Trump world felt that what they were doing leading up to January 6th and the Stop the Steal efforts was totally above board and that they had nothing to do with the violence that occurred that day and therefore have nothing to hide from this committee, then why would they need to reach out to people before they're going for depositions? Why would they need to remind people that Trump world is watching and they should, quote unquote, do the right thing? So I think it just further highlights that they are nervous about the investigation and perhaps do think that some things might come out that are not, if not criminally liable, could kind of expose them to the perception of wrongdoing.
And the committee has made clear, Congresswoman Liz Cheney has made clear, that she thinks even prior to the witness tampering that what occurred was illegal and that the actions that were taken were illegal. She uses the word illegal a lot when she's talking in that committee. And there's a reason, because a number of those members on the committee want the Justice Department to pursue this with its full force. There's also, just to quickly note, the Fulton County DA in Georgia is having its own investigation, and they are potentially looking at racketeering charges because those are possible in Georgia. And what's that? That's RICO, that's conspiracy under a boss.
I started my career in Rhode Island. There was an organized crime family. They're called the Patriarchers. And that's how you bring cases against the mob, through racketeering statutes like that. That's why it's so interesting. We're talking about statutes used against organized crime and the mob coming into play here. One of the things Vice Chair Cheney has done, and every member of the committee, is essentially look the people who won't cooperate in the eye and say, you don't know how much we know. We are getting so much cooperation. Maybe it's in your best interest to come tell us your story. Among those people is Pat Cipollone, the former Trump White House counsel. We now know the committee has issued a subpoena for Mr. Cipollone. Liz Cheney has publicly at several hearings said, why don't you come in and talk to us because you know just about everything. Here's what she told ABC.
Do you think that we will see Pat Cipollone testify?
I really hope we will. I think that this is an instance where the presidency, the American people, where we've been through something we've never been through before and where there's a very real and significant chance that, you know, that there was behavior underway about which Mr. Cipollone expressed significant legal concerns. and I think he has an obligation to testify.
Congresswoman Cheney says he has an obligation. Cipollone has cited privilege issues. He's the White House lawyer. He's not really the president's lawyer, but he's a lawyer for the institution. And he was involved in a lot of things where his own conduct could come into question. You have some reporting on whether this is a possibility or not.
The answer is it is a possibility, a very strong possibility. This is according to a lawyer who's familiar with the negotiations. The question is, what is the this? At this point, there is very little expectation that you're going to see him raising his right hand and alive a public testimony. Not saying it's totally out of the question, but the more likely route at this point is a behind closed doors transcribed interview, TBD on whether it would be recorded either with video or audio. And you can expect him to try to limit the questions, and he will be citing privilege on some of the issues.
No one needs to call Pat Cipollone. He already has your reporting that the president reads transcripts and the like of things like that. I appreciate the important reporting for us.